Welcome to the Box of Inspirations. The place where you get the best for you and your business from successful people and entrepreneurs.
I am Pamela Slim, and I am an author and a speaker, found at PamelaSlim.com. And today I wanted to talk to you about what it takes to be indispensable in this really wild and crazy world of work that we all find ourselves in. I've been a career coach for a long time, and one of the things that I've noticed is with so many opportunities, but also with so much uncertainty, it can be nerve-wracking to think about how you can keep yourself on your toes, highly employed, even if you might be doing things like moving between a full-time job, working for yourself. Maybe some of you have a side hustle alongside your business. And my focus and my interest is in really saying, what are these qualities and characteristics of people that no matter what happens, always seem to bounce back, always seem to be the kind of person that people want to work with? So a couple core ideas, and then I'll give you an example. One of the things I think that's the starting place for you to think about ways in which you can really be indispensable first is knowing what it is that you value and you believe. What's really important to you? What do you care about? What kind of person are you? What's your character? These are what I call your roots and the foundation of building your entire body of work. The second is knowing your ingredients. What are these special, unique things about you, your skills, your experience, your education? Things that really make you unique and that you can combine in interesting ways as you walk through your life and your work in a way that's really going to add value to many situations. So one of the people that's one of my dear friends and a favorite examples of somebody who combines some interesting ingredients to be somebody who is creating a really interesting and diverse body of work, but also is the kind of person who is very indispensable, who people want to work with, is actually my lawyer. His name is Kyle Durand. And the first stage of his career has been working for the U.S. Navy. So he grew up in the Navy. His dad and I think his grandfather as well were in the Navy. So his early path was in the military. And he's actually just finishing his service after 20-something years, ending up as a commander in the Navy. But through all those experiences that included a number of times being sent abroad in Iraq and Afghanistan, really living through some difficult situations, being blown up actually in Iraq, thankfully in a way that he could recover with a little bit of damage to his shoulder. That was a huge part of his experience. He also is trained as a lawyer. He's a postdoctorate tax attorney and is very passionate about the intelligent use of tax law so that people don't have to pay more taxes than they want. He's also an extreme athlete and does crazy things like fly to South Africa to compete in a double marathon. That's actually two marathons, so 52 miles, I'm not sure how many kilometers. So there's core components of what make Kyle really unique, where it seems like a lot of his experience is all over the place. But in fact, in the different efforts and endeavors that he does, in his service as a lawyer, providing guidance to business owners, he relies on core principles that he has of streamlining things, of reducing paperwork, of being efficient in business processes, because that's something that's really an interest and a passion, some of his roots. He also, having been a military veteran, is the kind of person who makes you feel very protected. And when you have a business partner like that, that's really important. And then I think with his extreme sports, he's somebody who also appeals to a certain market segment of people like me who are creative entrepreneurs who like people with all kinds of different ideas. And so while you step back and look at what seems to be a bit of a bizarre mix of skills and experience, like being in the military, being a tax attorney, and being an extreme athlete, they're actually things that make Kyle really, really indispensable for a certain part of the market. So I'm sharing his experience, which is probably very different than yours, but as you think about what it is that you want to build in the coming year and how it is that you really want to be positioning yourself in the market, either as an entrepreneur or as somebody that's adding value to your company, I encourage you to think about two things. The first is, What do you believe? What problems do you want to solve? What are your the core difference that you want to make in the world? This is defining your roots. The second thing is, what are all of your ingredients? What is experience that you may have discounted because it didn't seem to really be relevant to your work at hand? And I think you might find some things that will actually make you a lot more interesting and will add value to the workplace. So those are a couple ideas for you. I really want to thank Box of Inspirations for giving me the opportunity to share a couple of nuggets with you. I'm Pamela Slim, and you can find me at PamelaSlim.com.
Thanks for tuning in on today's episode. Head on over to BoxOfInspirations.com for full recaps and much more.